chocolate on it. And my got chocolate on it. Big bank take small. Bank account on some talk. Attitude on some. Bank roll on what it do, boo. He had the rule at five. And if I ain't did it yet, I'll try.
Big bank take low bank. Bank. Big bank take low bank. Bank. Type of money you gon' need to sight. The type of money you gon' need to buy.
The NFL on EA Sports brings us to North Carolina and Bank of America Stadium here in Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Arizona Cardinals. Here's Chandler Catanzaro ready to get this one started. And off we go from uptown Charlotte. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. This is Johnson. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
On second down, Johnson. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit
Detroit,
off a pretty
Detroit.
Decent game.
First down carry here for Johnson. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. Throw it with Rosen. He's going to air one out. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground, and it brings up third.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Going for the deep ball. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Adams, and he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts.
Blue 90!
First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17.
Back 51, back 51. Back 99, Philly, here we go.
Now Heinicke. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. On second down, McCaffrey. It's a gain of four, but they're still looking up here at a tough third and 11.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
They're going to look to throw. And he'll be hit as as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker roll that they can fall back on anymore.
Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback.
Arizona's offense coming back onto the field, and time for us to kind of assess what's happened this year for the Cardinals. And look, it hasn't been good. They're way below 500. Steve Wilks, first-year head coach, not what he expected.
Not at all. Not what the fans expected. Not what the organization expected. And truthfully, not what the NFL expected. Go back to preseason. Remember we were talking then? One more time. I'm not sure how to assess preseason anymore, but they look like a really buttoned-down organization. They were taking the ball away like crazy on defense in preseason. It looked like Steve Wilks had put a stamp on the team early, and it didn't turn out that way. But there is optimism because I think they've got a keeper in their quarterback, Josh Rosen, the rookie out of UCLA.
They'll look to throw on first down with Josh Rosen. He gets it left side to Johnson. And he's going to get this deep on a Carolina side of the field. A big time play there by the Cardinals. 47 yards. They'll try and run. This is Johnson. And that'll get him halfway there as he takes it from the 6 to the 3-yard line.
And Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
Touchdown, Arizona! Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. So a quarterback scramble, certainly a pass play, but he saw something, tucked it, and got in the end zone.
A lot of quarterbacks, when they scramble, they're scrambling to create more time to throw the ball downfield. In this situation, as you noted, he tucked it and took off. Great play by him.
Gonzalez now to kick this one away. On the return, it's Kenyon Barner.
Football going back over to the Carolina Panthers here, and for Carolina, it's hard to fathom what went wrong with them this season. It's been said before, we talked about it, they were 6-2 at the midway point, right in the mix for a first-round bye, and then everything kind of went wrong from there on out.
I wonder if we'll look back at that Thursday nighter in Pittsburgh, where they got absolutely blasted. And at the time, we thought it was kind of a one-off, you know? Bad night, throw it out, here we go. But that led to a really bad stretch of football for Carolina, a lot of losses. And you just wonder, did that game take so much out of them that it was hard for them to bounce back? Now, look, the playoff thing for them is going to figure on a lot of other teams and a lot of other factors. So they could be in or out depending on how other teams do. Bottom line is, they didn't take care of business themselves.
Yeah, and that Week 15 loss to the Saints, that kind of really sealed their fate. That put them 2 games below 500.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's 1st and 10, just outside the 30. Back to throw now on 1st down. He's going to fire one deep open, and this is caught. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore, 33 yards. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. Extra point up and good by Catanzaro. And we are tied at 7. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. Williams now on the return. Oh, what a move. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Airing this one out for Fitzgerald. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. A huge play there for Arizona. 58 yards. From the red zone now, here's Rosen on first down. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Mario Addison. He's the one that finally runs him down, and that is a big, big loss. 18 yards. On second down, here's Rosen. He's going to go for a big play down. And this is caught inside the five. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. That goes for a gain of 31. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Watch it now, Barney! Barney!
They'll come out throwing here on first down. To the right side, and he's got more complete. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down. They'll look to throw now on first down. And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 36. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
I do want to take this time to mention that the next few months, very big in the competitive Madden Championship Series. A few weeks ago, we saw Skimbo go back-to-back.
That's right, back-to-back, second straight year.
You're fired up. And then next up, the Madden Challenge, and it's a $190,000 prize pool, and the ladders to qualify for that tournament now available in Mutt Draft Mode. Exciting things. By the way, do you have a gamer tag, Charles?
No, I do not have a gamer tag. You must be a good player in order to earn a moniker.
Now, the first play of the drive there is incomplete. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course. They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Second and 10. It's Rosen again. He's going to wind up and air it out. Oh, wide open, complete. Touchdown, Cardinals. J.J. Nelson, 64 yards. And the Cardinals are able to show off their quick strike ability. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And it's now 21-7. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, it totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Hassan Reddick In from his linebacker spot, he's able to drop him for a loss of about 10. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back with more from Charlotte after this. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Detroit!
No run call here. They'll look to throw instead. Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. A special teams mistake there, no doubt. Just 26 yards officially on the punt. And the Cardinals, great field position to start this drive as they take over first and 10. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They go play action here on first down. He'll buy some time right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete. They're going for a receiver there. Already has one touchdown in his first half. A second one not to be.
I like where their headspace is, though. I mean, I really like the thought process, right? You got a guy who's already scored one, right? You want to go back to him, continue the hot hand, and make them adjust to you defensively. I like what they were trying to get done, even though they weren't successful.
Looking for Fitzgerald, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Adams. And it's a good return here as he'll get all the way up close to the 35.
Well, partner, like we always do this time of year with the holidays here and me happy for once, I want to say happy holidays to you, to your family, and to everybody out there in Madland.
I like how you said that. Before I do go on, though, happy holidays to you, your family, and
Thank you.
Out there in Madland as well. And hope that they're safe and they're happy and successful holidays for all. But as you said, happy for once. Usually you're kind of a Grinch this time of year. What's going on?
Yeah, well, my heart grew three sizes this winter.
I love it. Gotta get you some new clothes to accommodate that big chest.
But enjoy the holidays, everyone. Eat, be merry, enjoy your family time.
They'll set up the throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. He was trying to hit Thomas that time, and that'll bring up second down.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back in pass rush. They've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now back to throw. Got his target, Samuel. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He gets it to Thomas. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here, a nice route, able to look it in, and picks up the first down.
The first red zone opportunity for the Panthers thus far. First and 10 right at the 20. They'll drop the throw. That's caught. It's Thomas. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Ian Thomas, a 20-yard touchdown. And the Panthers are able to get this back within a touchdown. Extra point good by Catanzaro. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14.
Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. Williams to return. And nice work on the return as he'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Cardinal offense now making their way back out onto the field. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game. Yeah.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. Able to find a lot of empty space there, picking up the first down at a 21-yard gain.
Looks to me, partner, like he's learned a little bit, because earlier in the game, I think he was trying to force a lot of throws into some windows that just weren't open.
Yeah, the interceptions had plagued him, especially a second interception, really a bad throw. So maybe a better decision there.
Yeah, no doubt.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowler Luke Kuechly that picks it. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Final 10 seconds of the half as they've got it first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Steps away to his left. Taking a shot for Samuel. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left. Curtis Samuel, the one he was looking for. And now it's second down. Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up second and 10. They'll throw now on the final play. Eluding, and he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. So we have reached halftime with the visiting Cardinals out in front. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? Okay, Coach. Appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. The Cards with the lead, and they will get this football first as the second half gets started. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that.
Under pressure, they got him again. Marcus Golden in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. And he's out right at the 25. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
The Panthers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. He'll drop to throw. Open man is Samuel, complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Well, that'll get him the first down as they get 9 yards out of that quick slant. They'll look to throw here on first down. Over the middle, complete to Samuel. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. This quarterback now 11 of 17 passing thus far. He's got his guys a 1st and 10. The play fake. He'll look to throw. He's going to let this one go deep. This is caught inside the 15. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore, his 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game.
extra point up and good by Catanzaro. And we are tied at 21. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. Williams now on the return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark and maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some changeups you might expect.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete.
Whoosh.
And now past another. And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. David Johnson, 72 yards. And the Cardinals have broken the tie. And he knocks it through. Gonzalez now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Carolina getting set to take the field. They did what they had to do to start this third quarter, went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started at halftime.
Yeah, you're exactly right, partner. They had a little bounce in their step after scoring that first touchdown, but the defense gave one up. And that's the problem right now. Can they get better play from their defense while they continue to score on offense?
And he will lose yardage on the play, back at his own 19-yard line. And that's a loss of 7 on the first down play.
Well, that wasn't just a loss. That was a loss of big yardage there. So the sense you're starting to get is that offensively, things are starting to pile up against them. And they've got to find a way to stop that. Conversely, how about the great call by the defensive coordinator? He realized that he's got him on the run a little bit. That call was made to get upfield penetration by his defensive front to try and get into the gaps, get upfield into the backfield, and make a big play. I think that was actually called not so much just to, you know, to get it done that way, but to say, hey, guess what? We're going to be aggressive, and we had an opportunity and seized it.
Gun! Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and it'll bring up a second down. So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. We'll give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
It was funny, during the draft process, someone said to me, well, whoever takes Christian McCaffrey, as it turned out, it was Carolina, how are they going to use him? Is he going to be an every down back? Is he going to be a third down guy? They're going to use him in the slot? What are they going to do with him? And I just said, yes.
All of that.
No doubt about it. This kid can do it all.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Hassan Reddick in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot.
Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Marcus Golden in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
All right, here we go. 3-19.
Now Heinicke. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning, hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. They'll try and throw for it here. Forced out to his left. Now he's going to throw deep. This is caught at the 20.
And he will be taken down, but a big pickup there on what's going to be the final play of the third quarter. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10.
Detroit!
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And this will be incomplete.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. He'll set up to throw. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Call it a 1 yard gain on the play, and they're going to have a third down.
Well, it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
And he'll be brought down here at the 3 yard line. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now fourth down.
That was a good effort there, trying to do it on his own. But as a defender, you're in a tough spot because you have coverage responsibilities behind you. And if you take off too quick to try and get him down, he might have locked it over your head.
So better to track with your man defensively than try to go up and make a stop on the quarterback.
Exactly right. What you're hoping is that your guys in the front seven can get him down.
Down to Josh Rosen. And the most curious way there to burn some clock. That was wild. And at the end of all that, it winds up a safety. All right, Charles, help me out here. Fourth quarter, you've got the lead, and you run backwards into the end zone. You're just trying to do too much.
I almost don't have words for it. But you know, every coach that we talk to talks about running backs or people running the football, running north-south, getting upfield. He went way in the opposite direction. And that's going to cost his team.
Yeah, it cost him big time. Still leading, but it costs him. Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. And last time, they had it fourth and goal. Rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind him, try to put together another drive.
Hey, a simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. Under four to go now as they come up on second down. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Deion Buchanan in there to record another sack. Their sixth of the afternoon.
Detroit! Detroit! Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. He got 29 yards that time. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Over, 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 over!
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Flushed out right. Got a man right side. It's McCaffrey. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A very solid gain of 27. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Back to throw. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Ian Thomas with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Panthers have taken the lead here in the fourth. So a big play coming for the Panthers. They'll go for two.
Detroit! Detroit! Hurry up, here we go!
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And this is caught! And it's a three-point game! So that effort gives him a three-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy because that's all you care about. Not getting beat at this stage, at least give your team a fighting chance.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Cardinal offense here ready to take over. And the points, they have come fast and furious in this quarter.
You really don't want to be on the defensive side of the ball right now, do you? Because you're either thinking, my replacement may get an opportunity.
Your head better be on a swivel.
Totally. Or maybe I just need to get out of the game for a while because I just can't slow these guys down. They've got to figure out a way to disrupt these offenses. And typically, one guy makes a big play.
David Johnson on his way. The 20, 10, touchdown, Cardinals. David Johnson, 75 yards. And the Cardinals have taken the lead here in the fourth.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation. But to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late-game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
They have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. He's going to let it fly. This is caught at the 20. A big play there for Carolina. 53 yards.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there.
Detroit,
and now,
Detroit,
in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
He's back to throw. Dancing to his left. And this is caught. Touchdown. And they've taken the lead here in the final minute.
So from three scores down, these guys have fought all the way back to grab the lead. And I'll just tell people what happened. When they went up three scores, I wrote on your paper two words, game over, and now I'm eating those words. I was wrong.
Little salt, little pepper, goes down pretty easily.
I will admit when I make a mistake.
Well, it looked like it was going that way. This is one of those paging Frank Reich moments, and I can't believe I just brought that up, because Frank Reich at Maryland in college did it to my Tennessee Volunteers, and I was a big reason why my team lost.
Sounds like you still harbor some pain from that game.
You know, we still got a little time to work it out with the doctor.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock, so tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you, and this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Over, over.
I know they got a little yardage there, but I'm not sure their investment is right. They're still running the football, and I'm not sure there's enough time to continue to do that.
And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. And he finds Seals Jones complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go.
Gone. Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39. Green.
They'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. The protection really holding up that time. That's what you want in the two-minute drill, but the coverage equally as good.
Yeah, I'd say it was protection both sides, right? Get it for the quarterback, make sure he had time to throw the football, and he did. Plenty of time, but nowhere to go with it downfield. So the coverage, as you noted, terrific.
Gone.
He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly, and that is incomplete. 16 seconds now on the clock. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
3-19.
Throwing now is Rosen. This is Johnson. He's got it. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10.
Let's go. Blue 90.
Here's Rosen. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. They were looking for Johnson that time. Maybe he telegraphed it a little bit right there. You've got a cornerback knowing that he's going against a rookie quarterback. He stepped in and picked it.
You think he had a great week of preparation, looking forward to this opportunity? And the second part of that is, when you're a young quarterback, you are going to stare down targets. But oftentimes, your playbook hasn't expanded to give you full field reads as well. Makes it a little bit tougher for him.
Now a first carry for their fullback. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 5-yard line. A lot of scoring. There's no doubt about that in this one, Charles. Points, they were not at a premium. They were pretty easy to come by.
They were, but it was fun, wasn't it? Because both teams finding ways to click. And you know people who love this game, they also love baseball games that are 14-11 with 3 or 4 home runs mixed in.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Panthers are winners here as we say so long from Charlotte.